Hi Aries, it's Sloane Rhodes here with your spiritual guidance for the month of March. Cannot believe we're in March 2020. Okay Aries, this is your time to shine as well. Alright, so today I'm going to be drawing from the Mary L. Tarot by Marie White. It's a fabulous, crazy deck. I love it so much. Very sort of dark and brooding. Not really a spring type of feel, but I don't know, I just love it. Okay, so let's go ahead, Aries. And do a little past, present, future spread for you. All right, so we have the Five of Wands. We have this Nine of Cups in reverse. And we have the Four of Cups in reverse. And then we have the Queen of Swords under the deck in the reverse. There may have been an air sign, possibly. It's underlying energy that you've been dealing with recently, possibly a female, a Gemini, Libra, or an Aquarius person, or it could just be a person in the recent past. Well, I wouldn't even say in the recent past, just kind of an underlying energy here with the Queen of Swords of someone who really needs to be right. And maybe they've even been keeping an eye on you and trying and judging you. I'm going to leave it though, it's under the deck, I'm not going to spend too much time with it, but you can see in the upright, and here we have it here, in the reverse. Okay, so I'll show you the cards as I see them, Aries. So we have a past, present, future spread, the past being this Five of Wands, the present being this Nine of Cups in reverse, and the future of towards the end of March, you have the Four of Cups. Now these energies might elongate or compress, you know, depending upon your own energy and what's going on for you. But in general, it tells a story for March. All right, so running into March like the lion here, you're definitely coming through a very busy period. Maybe even a competitive period, or you felt like you had to compete with others, or you're just trying to get a lot done. You kind of made it through. Maybe even made it through the darkness, you know, it feels like in some ways with this card in the recent past, Aries. Through your will, through your determination, just going through. You're like, you know what, I'm just heading through it. You're not going to take the long way around. You're just going straight through. And it's led you here with this beautiful Nine of Cups energy. Now, even though the Nine of Cups is in the reverse, it's still really lovely energy. It does speak to getting, you know, getting your wishes granted, of course. There may be a Scorpio individual involved here. I feel like in a lot of ways for you, Aries, it's like you're sitting pretty. You're getting what you do want in general, but in some ways it feels like it's upside down, especially with this Four of Cups here. Like you're getting what you want, but you can't quite get your bearings yet. Don't worry, you will. It's just that you've embarked upon something that may be very new for you, and you're still trying to figure out how to make it work. Like your balance might feel a little bit off, your equilibrium. You may even have that physical sensation of ringing in your ears or, you know, something like that. But so it may feel like in some ways you've even entered an alternate universe. Like it seems like it's your life, but is it my life? You know, it's just because you're doing things differently. You've taken on something new here. Yeah, there may even be a Libra individual involved. But you're on solid ground, Aries. You really are. Just give it time to settle. Give the dust time to settle. You know, you've raced on through here. Diving headfirst, going through. You know, a very Aries energy. You're not going to mess around. You're not going to take this circuitous route. You're like, I'm going through. I'm Aries. You did it. You've done it. You're here. Nine of Cups, you're getting what you want, almost. But it's, with these two, it's just very, it feels very different. So again, just allow yourself time to get your bearings, to really get your feet on the floor. Do a lot of breathing exercises. Ground yourself. Sit cross-legged. Sit on the ground. Sit on the earth. You know, remind yourself that you're safe. You're exactly where you're meant to be here. And again, with that Four of Cups and the kind of the future, I kind of feel like these are really going together very, very nicely. Something completely different for you in a lot of ways. Here it is in the upright. The tried and true has been jettisoned, and you're like, yep, I'm doing something different. Feels uncomfortable, maybe. It doesn't feel bad. It's just, you're just like not sure here. What's going on? That's okay. It's all good. It's nothing bad here. It's just a matter of orienting yourself to your new surroundings or your new environment or the new way that you are being, even. Maybe something to do with the home as well, with that four. And this feels very kind of like almost like a edifice, you know, like it's a building of some kind. So, and here we have you going to the seaside. You know, I think last week as well, or last month, something to do with Aries. I'm an Aries moon, so I kind of remember that it was something about the sea, getting to the ocean or getting to water for you. This is for Aries Sun, Moon, Rising, by the way. So it may be that you do also move towards the ocean or towards the sea, or you want to get near the sea and it's different for you. Or maybe you're looking, maybe you're used to be on the Pacific and now you're looking at the Atlantic or wherever you happen to be in the world. Okay, so I hope that you find that helpful. It looks like a really nice month for you. I think the challenge, you know, will be kind of orienting yourself to this new place, this new surrounding, this new way of being, possibly. Whatever it may be for you, but you're safe, you know, and it's just a matter of grounding yourself, being with it a little for a little bit without judging it too much. Just kind of let it be as it is. It is what it is. It's different. It's all good, and you will adjust. You will get your bearings, Aries. So be gentle with yourself. this energy may have even left you a little bit burned out. So be very kind and gentle. Your emotions maybe kind of even feel upside down a little bit. That's just part of the process of the change and transformation that's occurring here. All right, Aries, I wish you much love. I hope that you found that helpful. Don't forget to check out the weekly spiritual guidance videos for additional insights. I do also release the Life Purpose Career and Money readings. I think the ones for March are already up. And I do have some meditation recordings coming out here on YouTube, and all of my videos are available in audio format, and there are links below. I'll see you next time. Bye.